everyone, welcome back to the channel. I've literally just pulled up on the driveway at home. I've come back from my 5k park run, which I do every Saturday morning when I can, except when I'm on club digs and rallies, obviously. But yeah, we're going out metal detecting today. For the first time in ages, I feel like I'm really excited to actually film a video. I feel like I've got my mojo back. The fields are in perfect condition. They're in stubble, some of them cultivated. I've got a couple of fields to go out today. If we try the first field and there's not a lot on there, then we'll move on to the second field. Really excited about today. The weather's perfect, the fields are perfect. I'm feeling good. Yeah, let's get out there and do it. We're out on a field where I had a couple of silver coins last year. It was the first time I'd been on it last year. I came on it for about an hour or so, and then it got drilled up for crops. So this is really about the second or third time I've ever been on this field for any length of time. We're going to give it the whole afternoon. Really excited about it. The sun's out, the birds are singing. I'm surrounded by beautiful British Suffolk countryside. What more can you want? All we need now is to make a few decent finds. Right, I'll be using the Minelab Manticore metal detector today. I'll be running on all terrain mode with my recovery speed set at 5 and the stabilizer set at about 2. I think that will do me for now. We'll see how we get on with those settings. Wish me luck. I'll see you at the first hole. Right, it's a little bit breezy up at the top of the hill. First signal I'm going to share with you all today is this nice 40-41. Not the perfect signal, but it's definitely, definitely diggable. I'll definitely take that as a first signal. Not too bad a signal, not perfect, but we'll take it. I think it's out. Let's see if we can find it with the pinpointer. Here it is. What is that? Oh, I don't believe it. Just a chunk of lead. Never mind. Right, the second signal I'm going to show you is a bit low, and I'm expecting it to be foil, but it's a 16-17. I'm still getting to know the manticore, so I'm digging everything at the moment. Definitely worth a go, isn't it? Sounds good. As I'm digging it out here, there is a little bit of depth to it, so you never know, it might be something good. Well, I just flicked it out with my spade, and it's not at all what I thought it was going to be. It's actually a little coin. Look at that. I think it's a Queen Elizabeth II sixpence. I'll see if I can get a date on it. I'll give it a clean up and I'll come back to you. It is an absolutely beautiful condition. I don't mind that at all. So our first coin of the day, our second find of the day. I'm really pleased with that. I don't find many of these, so I'll take that. Queen Elizabeth II, 1957, sixpence. Let's hope this is a sign of good stuff to come. Right, I've got another signal here. Not the best signal I've ever had, but not the worst. 23, 24, a little bit jumpy. I'm gonna give it a dig anyway because intrigue is getting the better of me. And it is just this bit of old rubbish. It says remove before use. Just a little cap off something, just a bit of aluminium. Never mind, let's move on. Well, filming in this wind is a bit of a challenge actually, but I'm not super excited about this signal, but it is another signal. It's a little bit iffy. It's got a bit of an iron grunt in there. 33, 34. Yeah, let's give it a dig just to find out. Right, I've been messing about trying to find this signal for a good few minutes now. It's actually deeper than I thought. And I've just missed it. I've just spotted it. It's right there in the sidewall. And it looks green. And it looks quite nice. I thought it was a shotgun cap right at the beginning, but I don't think it is. Oh, look at that. What is that? Oh, it's a nice little bit of buckle. Look at that, that's got some age to it. Wow. Oh, cool. I'm quite pleased with that, actually. It sounded a bit iffy because it's a bit of a gnarly shape, but look at that. Oh yeah, cool. I'm gonna give that a little bit of a clean up. Well, I didn't use any water. I just used my toothbrush. But yeah, I'm actually really quite pleased with that. It's got some age to it. I wouldn't like to guess how old, but yeah, I like it. Nice. Quite pleased with that for a signal that I thought was going to be iffy rubbish. Nice. Right, I've got another signal up here on the windy hill. I'm not super excited about it, but it's another one of these low tones. It's a 1920, but it's definitely diggable. It's quite a clean tone, even though
it's a low number. So I'm gonna take a chance on it, give it a dig.
And I was right to be skeptical. It's just a tatty old shotgun cap. What a load of rubbish. Never mind.
Right, I've come across this signal, exactly the sort of signal we're looking for. 32, 33, right in the middle of hammered territory. Could we be lucky? Find a hammered silver. You never know. I'm gonna live dig it with you, actually, this one. Let's have a little look. Fingers crossed. Best signal I've had all day. Oh, it's out. Let's have a little look. Grab the pinpointer. It's here somewhere. Is it in this block here? I think it is. It's in here somewhere. Where are we? Definitely in here. Small, whatever it is. Wow, very small, whatever it is. So I can't find it. Oh, it fell out wherever it is. Oh no, dropped it. What a nightmare. Well, I found it. Just in this little clod here. What is that? Ah, well, that's weird. It's a bit of lead. It's like a little round lead token or something. There's nothing on it. Appears to be blank. Well, that's a strange one. But that could so easily have been a hammered coin. Never mind. Right, I've come across a really high-pitched 90, 91, 92. I'm expecting it to be a bit of rubbishy aluminium. But we'll have a look. Yep, exactly that. Just a square of aluminium, nothing decent. On to the next. Right, I've got another decent 34, 35 signal here. It's a little bit of an iron grunt in there, but it's definitely diggable.
Well, it's just down there. Are we looking at the edge of a little silver coin? Oh, we could be, are we? Ah, no, it's a big pewter button. Never mind. Sounded good though. I'm still pleased. Oh, I thought that was going to be silver.
Right, I've come across another signal. It's been a little bit quiet the last half hour, but I've got a nice 54 there. Gonna give it a dig with you. I don't think it's very deep. It doesn't sound very deep. Might be right in the top there. Yeah, it's right in the top there. Don't think it's going to be anything amazing, but let's have a look. There somewhere. Ah, it's a huge button. Absolutely huge button. And it's got some decoration on it as well. And it's complete. Oh, wow. Oh, I'm not overly disappointed with that one at all. I'll get you on the other camera so I can show you the sort of nice detail patterning on it.
There we go. Can you just about see the nice pattern on there? Yeah, I like that. It's an absolutely massive button. It's huge. Look at that. I'm quite happy with that, to be honest with you.
Right, we've come across another signal. I've come back down to the bottom of the field and it's a little bit more active down here. And I've come across a nice 28. Lovely signal. In fact, we'll dig this one together, I think. Sounds really nice. Nicest signal I've had for a little while. Oh, I think it might be out already. Let's have a little look. Oh, can hear it. Where is it? I want to see it. I'll have to come back to you in a minute.
Well, it's out finally. It took me ages to find it. I think I'd actually dug slightly in the wrong place. Look at that. That is a beautiful little buckle. It's got some age to it. What a stunning patina on it. Look at that. Beautiful green, still with the pin intact. Really, really happy with that one. Look at that. That's got some age to it. That is going to clean up absolutely beautifully with a bit of wax. Lovely. Good stuff.
Right, I'm in a bit of a dip in the field actually, and it's a welcome break from the wind, so it's going to be easier to film. And I've just come across this absolutely exquisite solid 4950. Listen to that. That is an absolutely stunning signal. Just the sort of signal I want to hear.
Absolutely beautiful signal. Oh, that's a really good signal. I really hope that it doesn't disappoint. Oh, big clump there. And it's in that big lump somewhere. Right, definitely going to get our pinpointer on this one. I think it's out here somewhere. I missed it totally. Ah, it's green. What is that? Oh, it looks like a bit of a strap end or something like that. Not totally sure, but not the amazing find we were looking for. Just a bit of a strap end or something. But yeah, another signal, isn't it?
Right, next signal I'm going to show you is this. 62, 63. It's a little bit iffy, but it's definitely worth digging up, I think.
Well, I've spotted it. It's just down here. If it is what I think it is, I've never found one before. I think it is, yeah, I think it's a silver buckle. Oh, yes. Wow, look at that. It was the right numbers for silver. I will give it the quick spit and tinfoil test in a minute. Wow, a silver buckle, my first ever silver buckle. That is absolutely stunning as well. Look at that. I wouldn't like to guess an age, but maybe 18th century, 17th century, Georgian, maybe older. I don't know my buckles. If any of you have any idea on the age of this, then leave me a comment. While you're there, hit like, hit subscribe, all that stuff. Really appreciate it. That is stunning. Look at that beautiful silver buckle.
Well, I'm pretty confident that that is in fact silver, which makes it the find of the day for me. Look at that beautiful silver buckle. Fantastic.
Well, I've just stopped for a bit of a coffee break after finding that silver buckle. My mate Jack's turned up and he's brought the coffees with him. We've got a whole set up here. Fred's decided to come and have a wander and have a see what we're up to as well. There's a whole load of us out. What a glorious day. This ain't a bad spot to sit and have a coffee, is it?
Cheers, old boy. Cheers. Beautiful day.
Well, that was a well-earned coffee. Cheers for that, Jack. It's nice of him to come and meet me in the field. I'm going to go back, crack on, do some more metal detecting, and I'll see you at the next one.
Good luck. Happy digging.
Right, the next signal I've come across, there's a bit of iron there, and then there's a signal there. So it was a bit difficult to pick out, but there's definitely something nice and diggable down here. There it is. There's the iron. And there's the signal. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Oh, yes. Another lovely buckle. I think this is going to become the buckle field. Look at that. That's got some age to it, isn't it?
Right, I'm not too sure about this one. It's a little bit iffy. It's got a bit of an iron grunt in there, but I think it's worth a dig. There might be something nice down there, hiding amongst the iron. Well, I've dug it out. The target separation on this machine is absolutely insane. Because listen now. Now there's no iron near it. Sounds absolutely lovely. 28-29.
Well, it's out. I found it. It's just a piece of lead, but it sounded really iffy at the beginning. But once I separated it from the iron, yeah, nice. And we're in again. Nice 58 to 60.
little bit iffy, but I think it's jumping between tone breaks. I like that. I'm going to dig that.
Right, I've dug it out. It's just flicked out the hole. Can you see it down there?
And it is a broken piece of a crotal bell. Excellent stuff. I know it's broken, but we don't mind that. We're still on the finds, aren't we?
Right, my next signal. It's a bit jumpy from 77 right through to 80 odd. We'll give it a dig, find out. I'm not expecting anything special, but we'll give it a go.
Well, it's not the worst thing I've ever found. An old 303 bullet shell case. Again, we don't mind that because we're still coming across targets. We're out in the great outdoors doing what we love.
I was just scanning my eyes over the surface and I spotted this. This is a bit of typical Roman greyware pottery, and I think this is the rim of a pot, which is odd because I haven't found anything Roman on this field at all. There's a lot of Roman in the area, as you've seen by my other videos. If you haven't, go and check those out, but I haven't found anything Roman on this side of the village. This is interesting. Bit of Roman greyware pot.
Right, we're in again. This lovely 31, 32. Absolutely lovely, crisp signal. Just what I want to hear. Absolutely lovely. Still down there in the hole, there's a little bit of depth to it. Signal is shaping up to be one of the nicer ones of the day. And what is that down there? What is that down there? Oh my God. I think we've found a hammered coin. Oh yes. Oh yes. I'm gonna get you on the other camera.
Surely that has got to be a hammered coin. Oh, I don't wanna take it out the clod. I just wanna stare at it. It looks clipped, it looks worn. Ah, screw it, let's get it out. So I can get it out with one hand. Oh yes. Oh yes. Ah, absolutely brilliant. It is a hammered coin. Look at that. Oh yes. I absolutely love finding hammered silver. Wow, that is like really well worn on one side, isn't it? Or one half. Look at that.
And that is my second hammered since I've been using the Manticore. Absolutely chuffed to bits.
Edward I long cross penny is my guess. I'm so pleased with that. Yes.
Well, I've been out metal detecting for about 5 hours now. It's about 4:05. It's really, really hot still. It wasn't that hot this morning when I started, but it is really, really hot now. Just stopping for a quick drink. Keep hydrated, keep refreshed. Give it another hour or so. Really pleased with my finds today.
Well, it's been about 15, 20 minutes since I had that hammered coin. This is the first real diggable signal. Nice 22. Lovely tone, crisp. We're out already. We are out. Have a little look with the pinpointer. If I can find it out of my bag. There she is. Let's have a little look. Oh, there somewhere. Right here somewhere. What is that? See it in the clod there. Ah, oh, it looks like another button. But I don't mind that. Don't mind that at all. Lovely little button. Shank still intact but squashed. Lovely job. On to the next one. Right, I'm really excited about this signal. Solid 47, 48, all the way around. Oh, sounding a little bit iffy now, actually, I hate to say. That's better. Now it's a 51-52. Now it's out. We'll have a little look. Oh, there it is. What is that? I think it's just a chunk of lead. Yeah, it's a big chunk of lead. Lovely signal though. Here we go then. This target sounds absolutely lovely. Lovely 52, 53, 54. Solid dot on the target ID line. That is a cracking signal. Oh, what a stinker. It's another lump of lead. That was a lovely signal. Well, you can't have it always, can you? Right, we're in again. Faint 21-22. Tiny little target, I reckon. Very small. Not sure on depth, but it sounds good enough to dig to me. Here we go, another little button. I don't mind that at all, because that's just more evidence of activity on this field. More signals to be found. Lovely. Well, I had a signal, sounded a bit iffy, but I've just dug this lump out. Now listen to it. Beautiful 45, 46. I'm hoping it's not a bit of tin can, because I am quite close to the road now, and I'm hoping it's not a bit of junk that somebody's tossed out of their car window, but that sounds pretty good to me. Well, it's definitely not rubbish. It's this interesting little artifact. Looks like it's got a bit of age to it. I don't know what it is. Looks like it's broken off something there. Yeah, cool, I'll take that. Interesting little piece. Nice. Just dug up another button. This was ringing up a 19 signal on the Manticore. Yeah, another one to add to the collection.
Right, if you can believe it, got another signal. 45, 47. Not the best signal I've had all day, but I'd say worth a dig.
Another fascinating little find. This beautiful little lead weight. Cone shaped. Not quite sure what it would have been used for. Again, if any of you know, let me know in the comments. Yeah, nice little lead weight.
Right, I think this little low tone is going to be my last signal of the day. Little 15, 16. Nice little signal. Not expecting too much from it, but we'll have a little look.
And it is just this little folded up bent bit of tin. There we go.
Well, I think I'm going to call it a day there. It's been one of them truly memorable days. I can't believe what we found. We found some absolutely incredible things. It was lovely to see Jack at lunchtime and Freddie. They came to see me and brought coffee, which was much appreciated. But days like that out metal detecting don't come very often, and you just have to make the most of them when they do. So thanks for coming along with me today. I really appreciate it. And I'd love it if you hit that subscribe button if you've enjoyed the video. It'd mean the world to the channel. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you again very soon, I hope. Bye-bye.